we will be talking about reasoning ability. Now, reasoning ability plays a vital role in the personal development of every individual. So, I suggest that every person should be a champion of this part. Why? Because reasoning is what? It is basically questioning. So, the more you question about different situations, better you will be able to think. Your thinking power will also increase, it will enhance, and it will open your brains as to, it will lead to a creative thinking. More you will be able to analyze and evaluate different questions and different answers. So, in this video, we will be talking about number series, which is very important topic of reasoning section. Now, number series is basically, it is a series of numbers which are placed where each number is placed depending upon a different pattern. So, there the candidate is required to find out the pattern in which there are different terms which are placed in the series, and accordingly, there can be a question which can arise in order to find the missing term, or a question can be like there will be a particular series and you have to find the term which is wrongly placed or the term which does not follow the pattern. Now, for every series, there is a pattern which is made. For example, I say, like a simple pattern is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nothing can be as simple as this pattern. In whole, it is considered to be a series. But when I talk about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, on the individual basis, they are referred to as term. So here, what will be the next number? We all know that the next number will be 6. But on what basis is the 6 coming? It is like 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, 4 plus 1 is equal to 5, and 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Therefore, I am getting the answer as 6, which means that a certain pattern is formed. And what is the pattern? That the each resultant is being added to 1, or I can say 1 is being added to each resultant in order to get a new resultant. Here, 2 is my resultant or my output. Now, to this output or to this resultant, when 1 is added, I will get 3. Then, to this resultant, when 1 is added, I will get 4. So, similarly, now let us understand this concept through more examples. Now, this was my example number 2. Example number 1. Example number 2 can be like 1. 5, 9, 13, and what next? 1, 5, 9, 13, and my next number will be what? That depends according to the pattern. So here, my first and foremost condition is that I have to find out the pattern over here. Now 1 and next is 5. Here I have to find out the difference. The difference in this is 5 minus 1 is 4, right? Next, I will find the difference between these two terms. I will say 9 minus 5 is again 4. Again, when I find the difference between these two terms, I will say 13 minus 9 is again 4. So, the pattern is that in each of the following term, my difference is 4. Even in the next term, the difference is 4. I see that the corresponding number is bigger than the previous number. So, in order to find out the bigger number, I will add 4 to the 13th number. So, I will say 13 plus 4 is 17, and hence 17 will be the required term over here. Due to which, I will get my required answer, which is 17. Here again, I was adding 1 plus 1 makes 2, or it can be 2 minus 1 is 1, 3 minus 1 is 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, and 5 minus 4 is 1. So, the resultant was 1 over here and the resultant is 4 over here. Now, there are also chances like here with I was getting resultant as 4 over here. It may be chance that maybe all the time the resultant is not 4. Like the resultant is 2, 4, 6, 8. Again, I will say 2, 2 and 2. That this is resultant 1. But from resultant 1, I can also derive another resultant to form another series. So, let us consider this example so that we we can understand this concept in a better manner. So now my question over here is that I have to find the missing term over here in order to complete my series. My term numbers are 1, 6, 15, a blank, 45, 66 and 91. Again, I will take the help of the difference between the two terms. So my difference 1, will be 6 minus 1, which is 5. Next, I will consider 15 and 6. I will say 15 minus 6 is 9. So here my difference is 5. Here my difference is 9. Now there's a blank over here. So I do not know what is the number. So I cannot find the difference between this blank and this number. Neither can I find the difference between 45 and the blank. But yes, I can find the difference between 66 and 45. So I will say 66 minus 45 and I will get the answer as 21. 66 minus 45 is 21. So here my difference is 21. And here when I say 91 minus 66, so I will get the as 25. So 5, 9, then there's a question mark, 21 and 25. Here there are two blanks. One blank is this and another blank is this. I get the series as 5, 9, x1, x2. Why? Because two blanks are to be fulfilled over here. 21 and 25. This is a desired series that I have got from difference 1. From here, if I derive difference 2, when I derive difference 2, I say 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. I do not know the values of x1 and x2, so I will leave it as it is. Next, I will say 25 minus 21 is equal to 4. Now, my resultant over here is 4. So, I say 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Right? I can say like this. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. And when I say 9 plus 4, I will get 13. So, x1 can be 13. And when I say 13 plus 4, I can get 17. And x2 can be 17. And when I say 17 plus 4, I get the resultant as 21, correct? And 21 plus 4, I get 25, that is correct. So now 13 and 17 are my x1 and x2. I will put over here 13 and 17. I was getting the number as 5, 9. Next will be 13 and next will be 17. Now, I was getting like 1 plus 5 is equal to 6 and 6 plus 9 is equal to 15. Now, I will say 15 plus 13 is equal to 28 and 28 is my desired answer. 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. Here it is 9. 6 plus 9 is equal to 15. Next is 13. I will add 13 to 15. I will say 15 plus 13 is equal to 28. And so I know that 28 will be placed over here. So I get the desired term in order to complete the series. So in this way, we can complete the number series which involves difference. Here I have made you understand all the examples which include the finding of the missing number using the differences. In other videos, we will be talking about finding the missing series using division and multiplication as well. So till then, keep learning and keep practicing.